understanding of the feast. So we are just so misaligned. The modern day church is just so misaligned with the cycles of God. These seasonal portals also bring about miracles, signs, creative happenings, and healings during this time as experienced by the nation of Israel. Look at this graph. Understanding the feast and the times. The three great feasts, the three great harvests are Passover, Pentecost, and trumpets. They correspond to the first coming of Jesus, to the church age, and to the second coming of Jesus. And there are blessings assigned to each category of feasts and appointments. If you look at the menorah, it also speaks prophetically. Okay? Passover speaks of the cross of Jesus. Unleavened bread speaks of being cleansed from sin. Feast of first fruits correspond to the resurrection. Then Pentecost corresponds to the church age, which is holding the first coming of Jesus and holding the second coming of Jesus. So the church age is in the center. And then you have the Feast of Trumpets, which speaks of the regathering and the rapture, the Day of Atonement, which is for the atonement for Israel, and the Feast of Tabernacles, which is for all people, and particularly the Millennium Age. So even in the menorah, the feasts of the Lord are respected. It's just the modern day church that does not have an appreciation of the feast of the Lord. Now, having understood the feast of the Lord, where now is the glory of God? Where now is the glory of God? In this portion, I'll just give you a rundown of all the verses in the Bible about the glory of God. This will be quick, but just absorb this in your spirit. All of this will be straight from the Bible. What is the biblical concept of glory? Because we want to be on the glory side. We want to be on the goodness side. We want to be on the blessing side in this season. Okay. First, the Bible teaches that glory can sanctify and fill a place. Glory, the glory of God, can sanctify a place. Like this place. The tabernacle shall be sanctified by my glory. The glory of the Lord shall fill the tabernacle. Your house can be filled by the glory of the Lord, depending on what you do in that house. But glory can come to a place. Okay. Glory can appear physically. It's not just something that you believe in. It can manifest physically. The Lord said to Moses, or Moses said to the Lord, this is the thing which the Lord commanded you to do, and the glory of the Lord will appear to you. The glory can appear, the glory can be seen. When I was researching in the internet, in one activity, March 19, 2010, gold dust and gold nuggets fell in one praise and worship in one church because of the very thick presence and glory of the Lord. We have had several experiences in the Negros Island House of Prayer where gold dust and silver dust would fall on us. In the National Prayer Gathering, you ask the wife of Pastor Rolly, Sister Mitch, during the solemn assembly when we knelt and wept for the sins of the church and really cried for mercy of the Lord, there were so much gold dust and silver dust that fell. That was the first time it happened in the National Prayer Gathering that I can recall out of the many that I have attended. Glory can appear. God is given the glory when we confess sin. Joshua said to Achan, my son, I beg you, give glory to the Lord God of Israel and make confession to him. So glory is not only for the super, super holy, super, super cute. When a person is convicted of sin and confesses it and repents and asks for forgiveness, that is creating a glory atmosphere. We can go the right way, but without glory. Some people here in this world, Christians, do the service of the Lord without the glory of the Lord. Because you can do the work of the Lord without glory. This is in Judges chapter 4 verse 9 when Deborah said to Barak, because Barak will not go to fight Sisera without Deborah, she said, I will surely go with you, nevertheless there will be no glory for you in the journey you are taking. Some people just go through the mode of serving the Lord, but no glory accompanies them. Glory can change your status in life. When the glory of the Lord comes upon you, it can affect your status. He raises the poor from the dust and lifts the beggar from the ash heap to set them among princes and make them inherit the throne of glory. For the pillars of the earth are the Lord's, and He has set the world upon them. So when glory comes, even your economic, socio-economic status can change, because that is one work of the glory of the Lord. Praise declares the glory of God. Of course, this is the more familiar thing to us. Glory in His holy name, declare His glory, give to the Lord glory and strength when we praise the Lord. It creates an atmosphere of glory. Glory also protects. When the glory of the Lord is upon you, you are going to be protected. But you, O Lord, are a shield for me, my glory, and the one who lifts up my head. We also have a certain glory as men. But this is best offered to the Lord. Psalm 8:5. For you have made him a little lower than the angel, and you have crowned him with glory and honor. Speaking of human beings. Therefore, my heart is glad and my glory rejoices. I will explain this. Let me read the passages first. To the end that my glory may sing praise to you and not be silent. Awake my glory, awake lute and harp, I will awaken the dawn. Okay, what does this mean? The Lord has allowed a certain glory for men. Some of you here, for example, are successful businessmen. Some are respected professionals. There is a certain glory the Lord allowed you to enjoy. Use that glory to bring glory to the Lord. That is what it says, my glory may sing praise to you. As one you have blessed, as a successful professional, as one who has been promoted to higher position, my salary has been increased, that is glory. Lord, I, in my glory, bring glory to you. That is how it works. The Lord allows us a certain glory so that we may use our glory to bring Him glory. Glory protects and provides. For the Lord God is a sun and shield. The Lord will give grace and glory. No good thing will He withhold from those who walk uprightly. The glory of the Lord will see to it that you will always be provided. You will never lack anything good if you have the glory of the Lord. Glory attached to a place. It may be in your room. Glory may dwell in our land. Glorify the house of my glory. The glory of Lebanon shall come to you. Beautify the place of my sanctuary, and I will make the place of my feet glorious. Do you notice that in your house there are places there which are more conducive to spending time with the Lord than other places? Because sometimes, for example, in our house, my best spot is my prayer room. That's just everywhere. Sometimes even when I'm away from the prayer room, when I pray, I imagine that I'm in my prayer room. Because the revelation of the Lord that comes to me in my prayer room, it's a secured place. Nobody stays there except when it is being cleaned. And there's just the Bible there and the glory of God there. Glory can attach to a place. Glory can also be transferred. The Lord can take away glory from one place and put it to another place. Micah chapter 1 verse 15, I will yet bring an heir to you, O inhabitant of Maresha. The glory of Israel shall come to Adullam. So He can get it from here and bring it there. Adullam was the place where David first started, where worthless men surrounded him. Even if it is not so good a place, if the Lord is pleased, He can transfer glory here. Many times I would pray, sometimes when we are concerned that there are less people praying in New Hope, Lord, please do not remove your glory from this place. That's why we are campaigning. Let there be more prayer warriors and intercessors to come. The Lord might just remove His glory. Oh, may it not happen. But we're just praying, Lord, do not remove your glory, because there is glory in this place. The glory of God is a wall of fire of protection. When the glory of the Lord is there, there is a wall of fire. For I, says the Lord, will be a wall of fire all around her, and I will be the glory in her midst, the wall of fire. Glory is brought down by praise and wisdom. When we praise the Lord, we are joyful in glory. The glory of the Lord appears, but there is also glory in being wise. The wise shall inherit glory. She will place on your head an ornament of grace, a crown of glory she will deliver to you. A silver-haired head is a crown of glory if it is found in the way of righteousness. So the silver hair of Brother Butch is a crown of glory because he is walking in the way of righteousness. That's glory. People who are not easily offended, it's in the Bible, facilitate glory. Look at this verse. Proverbs 19:11. The discretion of a man makes him slow to anger, and his glory is to overlook a transgression. Do not be quick to be hurt and offended, because it is glorious to overlook an offense. It is not good to eat much honey, so to seek one's own glory is not glory. So do not seek your own glory. When you are hurt by other people, try your best not to be angry and just overlook it, because the Lord says that's glorious. The judgments of the Lord are also His glory. When He sends calamities or judgments, that is His glory. They shall go into the holes of the rocks and into the caves of the earth from the terror of the Lord and the glory of His majesty when He arises to shake the earth mightily. That's also the glory of the Lord. When He shakes the earth, that's glorious. His terror are also His glory. When He is provoked and He implements His holiness, that is also His glory. When glory comes upon us, there is covering, because covering is always associated with glory. The Lord will create above every dwelling place of Mount Zion and above her assemblies a cloud and smoke by day and a shining of a flaming fire by night. For over all the glory, there will be a covering. For over all the glory, there will be a covering. There will be a covering for those who live in the glory of the Lord. Do you know that people going to hell also have their own glory? They have their own brand of glory. Isaiah 5:14. Therefore, Sheol has enlarged itself and opened its mouth beyond measure. Their glory and their multitude and their pomp. And he who is jubilant shall descend into it, shall descend into Sheol, or the abode of the dead, or hell. They have a deceptive kind of glory. Even here on earth, those, the drug traffickers and the corrupt people, when you see them, they are glorious. They have status and pomp and their tigas. So that's quote-unquote glory, but they are going into hell if they do not repent. What will you do in the day of punishment and in the desolation which will come from afar? To whom will you flee for help? And where will you leave your glory? Earthly glory will be judged. Those who glory in themselves will someday be judged. Babylon, the glory of kingdoms, the beauty of the Chaldean bride will be as when God overthrew Sodom and Gomorrah. All the kings of the nations, all of them sleep in glory. Everyone is in his own house. But here is a very important thing. Do you know that glory fluctuates? Sometimes it's high, sometimes it's low in our lives, depending on our walk. There are times when we are just really just floating in glory, and there are times when we are living on scrimping of glory. Here is the verse, Isaiah 17:4. In that day it shall come to pass that the glory of Jacob will wane, not really disappear, but will wane, will flicker. And the fatness of his flesh will grow lean. So glory has a rise and fall. And glory can be subject to time limit. There is a time limit sometimes when you can enjoy glory. It depends on how you walk with the Lord. For thus the Lord has said to me, within a year, according to the year of a hired ram, my hired man, all the glory of Kedar will fall. In another place, Isaiah 16 verse 14, he said, within 3 years, as the years of a hired man, the glory of Moab will be despised. So sometimes the Lord looks at you, looks at us, and then He observes us. Then He decides, if this is how it goes, okay, I'll give him one more year of glory, then I'll remove it from him. If we do not check our walk, the glory can be given a time limit. Glory is transferable from one person to another. Not only from one place, but from one person to another. Sometimes He sees a person, He has given this one person a blessing, he abuses it, and then another person he sees walking with the Lord humbly, he can transfer the glory. Here is a classic case, Isaiah 22. He was looking at Shebna.